Well, hello, fellow procrastinator. Yes, you and I both waited too long to drain our sprinkler system, and now my backflow preventer leaks. I noticed it one day. It was actually warm. It froze, and then when it thawed, water started pouring out of the top on the house. I had to go in the basement and shut it off. So now I have to replace the internal parts. And it's actually pretty smart that the whole unit doesn't break, just the internal parts are designed to break first. Now, most videos I've seen, people have a poppet and a internal plastic parts, two plastic parts that they have to replace. Mine's a little different. It has a brass fitting, and I'll show you that. This is the part here that broke, and you can see that it broke, it popped up, and it cracked right there. So I bought replacement parts right here. I think they were about 20 or 30 bucks, and I just have to install them in the unit. Mine has a spring. Mine's actually a Wilkins 720A, and it also has Zurn on it. And I think all these internal parts are good here. This was the kit it gave me, so I'm just going to replace this here. This is the main part that broke. You can see this one's nice and straight, and this is the one that cracked and popped up, and that's designed to break. So I just have to replace this washer with this washer and then put it all back together. And in the instructions on the kit, they give you some grease to put on that gasket so that it moves. So the rest of the assembly for mine is that sits on top. That goes in through the hole there. And then that gets dropped right in there and screwed in. And then the cap goes right on top. Lock it all up with the screws, three screws. All right, so that was it. It was actually a really quick fix. It only took about 3 minutes. Granted, I did take all these internal broken pieces out in the middle of the night when water was pouring on the house and I had to shut off the main water supply to this. That was a pain, but actually putting the kit in, they just put silicone grease on the gasket, which I actually left the old gasket in there. I couldn't get it out and it looked pretty good. So I just put silicone grease on that gasket. Screwed the brass fitting down with the internal dampener in there, and it should be good as new. So now we got to test it, and then, since this is the last warm day of the year, we're going to flush out all these lines. So you can see they're all...
As you can see right there.
Well, I hope you liked the video you just watched. If you did, feel free to subscribe by clicking the button on this side. You can also check out all the videos I've done, the playlist from things I've built, things I've fixed, home repair, 3D printing. And on this side, you can check out a recommended video similar to the one you just watched. And as always, down in the description, I'll put a link to my blog, which has more pictures and more information about the video you just watched. Thanks.